Big.
Big.
Big, so big.
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 Big. It's big.
Welcome to my farm. I'm thrilled to be hosting our first show from my home in Katona, Bedford in Westchester County, New York. These 153 acres of tranquility are called Cantato Corners. I've owned the property since the year 2000, and after lots of restoration and lots of renovation, I made it my home. There's a beautiful stable and several houses on the property, which means lots of work and lots of upkeep. We all know about that. I live in the winter house, originally built in 1925. I share this land with many animals, and now I'd like to share my home with you. Here I am in front of my house, and I'm delighted because we have a live audience. I hope you all had a wonderful summer. My summer was really busy, and I traveled a lot. Many of you may have followed my travels on my blog, and I'll tell you more about that on tomorrow's show. For everyone here today, I've invited some special guests to prepare lunch for us. Chef Joey Campanaro from the Little Owl and Market Table in Manhattan is here to cook up something really delicious. Four of my favorite chefs to my farm today to cook some of their specialties. We have New York's Joey Campanaro of the very popular Little Owl. Hi, Joey. When we come back, we'll be in my vegetable garden harvesting some of my late summer crops. And coming up, learn the secret to Joey's bacon cheeseburger and the recipe for Scott's favorite side dishes. Grills, and now Weber Grills, by the way, and I want to spend some time with Joey Campanaro and Scott Peacock. They're sharing this big, beautiful table. And Joey, let's start with the cheeseburgers.
Fantastic.
These are so beautiful, and the meat looks so good.
Yes, thank you. This is it's a proprietary blend that Pat LaFreda and I worked together on.
I hope it's all beef.
It's all beef.
I've been eating it raw.
It's all beef, and what we do is we mix. It's a ground sirloin and it's a ground brisket.
Is this one of the? This is one of the most popular dishes at the restaurant.
At lunch and at brunch. We don't serve it at dinner.
No.
Just at lunch and brunch. So what I like to do is mix the meat, and we form 8-ounce patties.
Okay. So brisket and sirloin.
Brisket and sirloin. Mm. That's correct. Okay. And Pat chops it at his store, and he's at the shop down in Greenwich Village, which is right by the restaurant.
So now how big is this? I
mean, this is a big one. This is, we want to look at.
About that size?
Yeah, that's, let me feel it. That's a little off, Martha.
Off? Really? How much off? How much off?
There you go, just a little bit more. Perfect. And then I roll it into a big ball, and then with my thumbs pushing down, I just try and get it into a little disc. Now this has a lot of fat in it.
Mm, that's what makes it so good.
And it's what keeps it juicy.
So you don't put it on the board. You do it all in your hands?
All in my hands.
Okay.
Right? And then we have some formed over here.
Now how did you get them so perfect?
Pat does them for me.
Oh, okay. it looks like they're almost cut with a cookie cutter.
They actually
does he have a ring?
They chop it together and it's a die basically. That the meat gets pressed into, works out perfectly.
Mine's looking almost as good.
Oh, yours looks better than Pat's. Mm-hmm. And then I take a seasoning mixture of cayenne pepper, curry, and salt. And if you could mix those together.
Okay, all of these?
Yeah.
So 2 tablespoons of kosher salt, cayenne pepper. 2 tablespoons of cayenne pepper. I thought that was a mistake.
We're not going to use it all. We're just going to sprinkle it
on. And 2 tablespoons of curry powder.
That's correct.
So it's all in the flavoring, isn't it?
Yes. Mm. And this I like to use this spice mix because it gives a little bit of heat, of course, and a little bit of funk from the curry because people wonder, what is that? What is that flavor? What makes your burger taste different? Well, you know, we have 2 restaurants.
How many of you would describe your hamburgers as funky? Joey. Okay, now.
And then I'll just season them.
Okay. Oh, so you're not dipping them in.
Oh, no. This is not with all that. We just want to enhance the meat a little bit. And then when this spice mix mixes with the juices And when the fat renders, it caramelizes on the outside of the burgers.
So salt, pepper on top of the spice. Okay.
Exactly.
And these are so beautiful. And Joey says he makes them himself. And the secret ingredient?
It's molasses.
Oh, they smell so
molasses
good.
Molasses instead of sugar.
So this is a nice light bread dough.
It's basically a pizza dough. But what happens is these burgers are so juicy that you really need something to hold the juices.
Right, so they're hard on the outside, but so tender on the inside.
Yes.
And the secret ingredient, molasses. Thank you for sharing that.
You're welcome.
That's fantastic. Okay.
And then I serve the burgers at the little out lunch with lettuce, tomatoes, and...
Are these getting overdone?
Yes.
Yes.
And pickles. And how appropriate that we have Rick's Pickles here today.
Okay, so now...
We need to put some lettuce, tomato, and onion on the side of the plate
but you cook
or
the
on the
cheese,
burger.
Right? Okay, so let's start. What's first? Lettuce?
Lettuce down.
Yep. Okay.
And then the tomato and then the onion on top.
Okay, lettuce down.
Perfect.
Then onion.
Right, and then the tomato.
I always like to sort of break it up a little bit so it's easier to eat. And then how many tomatoes?
Just one tomato.
Oh, just one. Okay.
And then I also love to season the salt.
Please do.
Salt and a little pepper on the tomato.
Okay.
And then can you help me over at the grill?
Yep.
Fantastic. We can, what I like, another rule of thumb for me is to put the bacon underneath the cheese.
And plenty of it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm coming here for brunch soon. Oh, boy, I had no idea you made cheeseburgers there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to stand on this side.
Great.
And what kind of bacon?
This is Hatfield smoked bacon. It's an applewood smoked bacon.
And really nice cheddar. Here, keep moving around.
And we cut this by hand at the restaurant. And I like a nice thick slice of bacon.
And one piece of cheese?
Yeah, just one piece of cheese I think is perfect. I can take that for you.
And there. Mm.
And I'll bring the plate over for you.
Okay, yeah, the cheese is just starting to go. Oh, yum. So beautiful. Wow. That is delicious. Well, I've made my choice. You'll be learning more and seeing more of this beautiful chow chow in the coming year. And don't forget to tune in tomorrow to learn more about our exciting cooking school sweepstakes. Very, very fantastic. And now it's time to eat. Thanks, chefs. See you tomorrow.